Hi, everyone. James Murphy here. And as of October 5th, 2020, Python 3.9 has been officially released. So today, we're going to be taking a look at one of the new features that was introduced in Python 3.9, namely the dictionary OR operator, more formally called the dictionary union operator, or sometimes the pipe operator. So let's take a look. Previously, in Python 3.8, it was pretty easy to combine two lists. So if I have my list D, 1, 2, 3, and my list E, which is just 4, then using plus, we can combine them to get a new list. Similarly with sets, we can use the pipe operator to do the set union. But there was no way to combine two dictionaries. Well, in Python 3.9, that has been added. You can now use the pipe operator, as seen here, to combine two dictionaries. So if I have spam, eggs, and cheese being mapped to 1, 2, and 3, and extra being mapped to 4, then if I take D pipe E, then I get spam, eggs, cheese, and extra being 1, 2, 3, and 4. I've also added these two assert statements to show that the pipe operator does not modify D or E, so I'm just asserting that they have been unchanged. And the reason that this pipe operator here is highlighted is because my editor doesn't know about Python 3.9 syntax yet, so it knows that these two are dictionaries and it thinks that you can't do that, but you can now. And just to prove it, we'll go ahead and run this test, and indeed, it all passes. Moving on to the next one, what happens if our two dictionaries, D and E, share a key? So in this case, the key cheese occurs both in D and in E, and moreover, the values 3 and 5 are not equal. So what does it do? Well, it's not an error. It's a well-defined behavior. All it does is take the last seen value. So since E came last, it uses the value of cheese from E. So we end up with spam 1, eggs 2, cheese 5, and extra 4. And again, D and E are unchanged. Notice, though, that this implies that the order that you do the operation in matters. So this next test is just the same D and E, but I'm pointing out here that if you do D pipe E, that's not the same as doing E pipe D. So we say that this means that the pipe operator is not commutative. And of course, the reason for this is because in the first case, E came last, so cheese gets the value 5. But in the second case, D came last, so cheese gets the value 3. Now, this might seem weird, and actually, this was a major point of contention on whether or not the pipe operator should even be added to the Python language. But when you think about it, there are a lot of operators in Python that, while mathematically it might seem like they should be commutative, in Python they just aren't. So in this example, we see that even the plain old regular OR operator, which mathematically is definitely commutative, is not going to be a commutative operator in Python. So here, if A is true and B is 1, of course, A is not the same thing as B. Those are different values. But if we look at the expression A or B, that gives you A. And the expression B or A, that gives you B. So depending on whether I say A or B or A, I get a different answer. And just to prove that that is in fact what's happening, let me run the test to show you. And indeed, we see the test passes. So because even the plain old OR operator is incommutative, there was really not much point in fussing over it for the dictionary OR operator. The next test looks at the or equals operator, which is similar to the or operator for dictionaries, but it does the operation in place on the dictionary. So in this case, D pipe equals E actually modifies D, updating it with the contents of E. So the results would be the same as D pipe E, except it's automatically assigning it into the variable D. This is the same as D.updateE, which did exist previously in Python 3.8. However, D pipe equals E is an assignment, and it's treated just like D equals E. It doesn't have a value. So I could not say something like compare D pipe equals E to some dictionary. That's just a syntax error. Just like I couldn't say D equals E equals some dictionary. So this differs from the walrus operator, which looks like this. Now, this would not be valid in Python either, just because you can't have a walrus operator by itself. But the walrus operator does an assignment, but also returns the expression, whereas the pipe equals operator just does the assignment, similar to the equals operator. Finally, I'd like to point out one gotcha that might come up when using the pipe operator. Because this notation is now so short, you might be tempted to chain some pipe operators together. And this is perfectly valid syntax. This will work just fine, and it will do what you'd expect, as long as you know what the pipe operator is, of course. However, you're going to run into the same kind of trouble that you would if all of these were lists and you said A plus B plus C plus D. Namely, every time you do a plus, you're creating a temporary copy. So A or B or C or D is creating a bunch of temporary variables that just get thrown away by the time the last one comes around. So in this example, I'm going to be using these four dictionaries of random integers and trying to merge them together in two different ways. The first, using this naive method of just chaining pipes together, and the second is just using a for loop and using the pipe equals operator to add them in one after another. So in this second example, there's no temporaries being created. The or equals operator is acting directly on E, and no temporary is needed in between. So I just look at the start, I do the computation, and then I compute how long it took, and then I print out the values. Similarly, I get the start time, I do the computation, and then see how long it took and print out the value. And for this test, I'm actually going to assert that there's a positive improvement by using this method. Now, this might be a little silly because improvements like this, you know, maybe if I ran the test several times, I would get different answers. But just trust me, the improvement is quite significant. So let's go ahead and run this test. So you can see, in this test, just scrolling down to where the things were printed, we see that there was an improvement of 105 milliseconds just by not using temporaries, just chaining four dictionaries together. So that's quite a bit of improvement depending on how time sensitive your application is. So that's all I wanted to show for this video. So thanks everyone for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one. I'm thinking of going into more details about other features introduced in Python 3.9. Also, I'm actually starting a company where I'm going to be offering live online courses in Python. They're going to be full-length courses lasting 9 weeks long. So if you're interested in signing up for one of those courses, go ahead and look in the description where I've put a link to a form where you can give me your contact information to be notified when these courses are going to be available.